30 years in the future. We are fighting a war. Our enemy is not human, and we are losing. We need you to fight.
You heard about the cave-in?
Yeah.
I'm putting together a rescue mission. He's a mechanic.
One of the best.
A. D. N.
It's headphones deal!
What's up, guys? Headphones Neil here, back with a quick double feature film review in the form of the Netflix film The Ice Road and the Amazon Prime movie The Tomorrow War. So I wasn't really planning on watching these films, but it kept showing up on social media as generally positive films to watch and generally well-favored movies to watch. I was like, all right, well, I'm going to take a break from watching Gotham and check out these two movies to see if they're any good, see if I like it, don't like it, and all that. And overall, for me, the films felt generally average. I didn't really find anything particularly good or bad for either of them. If I was to grade the better of the films, I probably found maybe Ice Road a little bit better. In general, the acting was overall pretty good. It's a matter of miners getting stuck in a diamond mine and Liam Neeson having to go take a rig over an ice road to get to them so that those miners can be saved, and how the company was trying to cover it up. And overall, so that was good, but as far as the acting from Liam Neeson goes, and it was my biggest problem, is that it felt like his acting from Taken, but kind of semi-phoning it in. It didn't feel as good, as impactful, or anything like that. I mean, scenes mostly with his brother felt like they could, while for me impactful because of the acting of the brother, felt like they could have been done a little bit better. For me, it feels like Liam Neeson could have helped elevate this film a little bit more than he did. So it was kind of strange, to the point where it also felt like, on the flip side, that he was giving more of the screen presence to the other actors, like the guy who played his brother, to Tantru, to the guy traveling with them, to who was working on behalf of the insurance company. Lawrence Fishburne's acting was okay. It generally kind of works, so can't complain too much about it. So there was that. So overall, an okay film. I liked the idea behind it. So there was that. And for me, I didn't really find any part of the film to be boring. So that's kind of why I'm giving it a more positive view of the film or rating than I would have otherwise. And a similar thing goes for The Tomorrow War. So as far as Chris Pratt's acting goes, for me, he's kind of fallen into that role in this film as far as somewhere between Star-Lord and the character he plays in Jurassic World. So like the beginning part of the film felt very much of Star-Lord in Guardians of the Galaxy, but then the rest of the film felt very much along the lines of his character in Jurassic World. So for me, that all was fine. The relationship with his wife and daughter and all of that was fine. But my biggest problem with the film, and they kind of resolved it, but it was kind of weird, was when he's in the future with his older daughter, he's talking about bringing her back, which I guess is a way of saying that they don't really understand how time travel works. So that could potentially be a problem in bringing his future daughter back and potentially introducing her to his young daughter. And that's like the second part of the whole thing about potentially meeting your future self, because they're sending people to the future for people, notably people who have already died by the time of the war. So that all generally held up for me, but I don't know, it felt like a weird like by the time we get to introducing the main villains of the film, it felt like interesting portrayal of Half-Life, but in as a live-action movie. So for me, that kind of made it a little bit better. But for some reason, I couldn't shake the feeling that something was a little off about it. So the only thing I could really think of was that it felt kind of like a variation on the Tom Cruise film Live, Die, Repeat, where they're trying to fix a future war by bringing people from the past into the future to solve it, but then also sending them back. But then they don't really bring up any of the issues of doing time travel by meeting your future self or past self, or sharing the knowledge of what you see in the future. I guess potentially because they've already come from the future to the past, so it creates, I guess, in my mind, a weird time paradox, so it doesn't really sit well with me. And then Chris Pratt goes on and tells his wife about meeting their future daughter and how they changed the future, so to me that kind of messes with the present a little bit, I guess, but he doesn't tell her about how they got divorced and how he dies and all that, so it's kind of semi-changing the future, I guess, so there's that. And then they go out to find those weird alien things that have been burrowing under the earth for thousands of years, so I guess for me it's like they potentially started with an issue, but then they didn't end with it, so they kind of had self-resolving things in the movie, so I don't know, just felt like a weirder version of Live, Die, Repeat, like I said. So if I was to grade this film, I'd probably give it about a B to B minus. It was okay. I didn't really find anything particularly wrong because it feels like they solved a lot of stuff in the film. But by not really sharing that, or by saying that, or not really sharing from what I could tell, that they're not allowed to share what they saw with anyone in the past, then it kind of feels like the situation can get out of control. And then with the ice road, I think it's about the same, it's about a level of a B to B minus. It was basically another Taken movie with Liam Neeson, where kind of like Taken mixed a little bit with John Wick without all the gunplay. So like I said, the acting felt okay by Liam Neeson, but then it felt like he was trying to give enough screen time to all the other characters. With the Tomorrow War, it felt Chris Pratt's character just felt too much like his other characters that we've seen him in recently, so it feels like it could have been better. But I don't know, just I'm not gonna say that Chris Pratt is typecast in any role, because I liked his portrayal as Star-Lord and his character from Jurassic World. And same thing with Liam Neeson, that with his acting in, like, for example, the Taken films, that's very well done with what he does. But then translated outside of that into, for example, the Ice Road, it's kind of okay, and it feels like one of those things where there's very little adjustment with the character or the portrayal, and it could have been adjusted a little bit better. So that's all there is for this particular review of the film. So as far as recommendations, it's not really one of those, they're not really films to run out and go see, but if you're a fan of Liam Neeson, then I would say watch The Ice Road, and same thing with The Tomorrow War. If you're a fan of Chris Pratt, then watch that. But they're not really films I would, you know, run out and go see or put money down on. They're good for rentals, or in this case streaming. If you're already a Netflix and Amazon Prime subscriber, then they're okay to watch, but not really to go run out and go see. So there's that. So that's all there is for this particular review. So if you have any questions, comments, concerns, feedback, your own thoughts on the film, you can find me on Twitter at PatelN01. The website is headphonesneil.reviews for past episodes, subscription links, supporting the show, and all of that good stuff. But that's all there is for this particular review. Thanks for tuning in, and until next time.